Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Lawrence Welk Show, celebrating more than 60 years on television. Now sit back and enjoy the show selected especially for public television.
Hello, I'm Mary Lou Metzger, and welcome to the Lawrence Welk Show. This was the season premiere show, taped in Hawaii in 1972, and what a great adventure it was. Clay Hart sings Pearly Shells, Bobby and Cissy dance to Paradise, and Charlotte Harris has a beautiful solo on Blue Hawaii. And speaking of Charlotte, she'll be here for a visit at the end of the program, and we'll reflect on her many years with the Lawrence Welk Show, so stay with us. But now, let's go to Hawaii.
The Lawrence Welk Network presents Lawrence Welk and his musical family with their season's premiere. And now, from the Los Angeles International Airport, here's Lawrence Welk.
Greetings, my friends, or maybe I should say aloha. Yes, for our first show of this new season, our 18th year, thanks to you good people. We have a very special treat for you. We're going to bring you a show direct from Hawaii. And right now, we're at the Western Airlines boarding gate, getting ready to take off on Western's Islander flight to Honolulu. Our boys and girls are getting aboard, so folks, let's join them. What a friendly audience, and what a delightful trip. And as the song said, we're now on the beach at Waikiki, right in front of the fabulous Sheraton Waikiki Hotel. Clay Hart, Sandy, and Sally are wasting no time getting into the spirit of the islands. Let's all get into the spirit.
Pearly shell, from the ocean,
from the ocean,
shining in the sun,
shining in the sun,
covering the shore,
covering the shore.
When I see them, my heart tells me that I love you more than all the little pearly shells.
For every grain of sand upon the beach, I've got a kiss for you.
And I've got more left over for each star that twinkles in the dew.
Pearly shell,
pearly shell,
from the ocean,
from the ocean,
shining in the sun,
shining in the sun,
covering the shore,
covering the shore. When I see them, my
good time here in Hawaii. Now let's have some dance music, and I might tell you folks, everyone is a dancer here in the islands, as you will see. A pretty island love song, and our lovely champagne lady, Norma Zimmer, to sing it for you. We find Norma on a balcony at the Surfrider Hotel.
We'll keep forget. I'll say
a beautiful song, a beautiful view. The music from the show South Pacific is quite in keeping with this lovely island setting. We're going to ask our musical supervisor, George Cates, to make one of his rare appearances on camera. He's gonna conduct the orchestra in a medley of these great songs. George, be my guest. Of you, and I'm so glad I've kept you with us for 21 years. Everyone in Hawaii seems to have the aloha spirit. It's a combination of friendliness, happiness, hospitality, and fun. I think you'll get the idea as Tanya makes friends with some of the nice folks in our audience. Tanya?
Hookillau, Hooky, 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 Hookillau. Everybody loves the Hookillau. Where the lau lau is the cow cow at the Hookillau. Oh, we throw our nets right into the sea, and all the armor armor come swimming to me. Oh, we're going to the Hookillau. Hooky, 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 Hookillau.
Okay, I want to get some volunteers from the audience. Now, everybody has to know this dance if you come to Hawaii, and I want everybody to sing along. Come on. Now, don't be shy, because you won't be Hawaiian unless you do it. Okay, now follow me.
Oh, we're going to the Hookillau. Hooky, 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 Hookillau. Everybody loves the Hookillau. Hooky, 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 lau. Oh, we're going to the hooky lau. Hooky, 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 lau. Everybody loves the hooky lau. Where the lau lau is the cow cow at the hooky lau.
Oh, we throw our nets right into the sea, and all the armor armor come a swimming to me.
Oh, we're going to the Hookillau. Hooky, 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 Hookillau.
Now here's a song that has long been associated with Hawaii. Let's join Gail and Dale. They're on their way to the Hanohana room at the top of the Sheraton Waikiki.
Tiny bubble,
tiny bubble,
in the wine,
in the wine.
Make me happy,
make me happy,
make me feel fine,
make me feel fine. Tiny bubble,
make me warm all over, with a feeling that I'm gonna love you too. The golden moon,
and here's to the silver sea, and mostly here's a toast to you and me. Tiny bubble,
ooh-a-lee,
in the wine,
kick-a-ba-ina.
Next, we have a graceful waltz by our wonderful young dance couple, Bobby and Cissy. The title of the song describes these beautiful islands, paradise.
Thank you.
exciting music, lovely surroundings, and a fine performance by Bobby and Cissy. Hawaii is famous for many things, including its friendly, lighthearted, and interesting people. Gail Farrell and Mary Lou Metzger tell us the story of a colorful island character.
Oh, he don't know what it's all about. He's gonna run the town till they run him out. Maybe you know why such a cockeyed guy became the cockeyed mayor of Kaunakakai. All matters legislative he positively will neglect. For some attractive native he's guaranteed to protect. He gets to work at 10, takes a nap, and then plays cards with a couple of aldermen. Then at 2:30, when all his work is through, he will count all the duties he did not do. He has lots of honorary, very dignified college degrees. He's not mercenary, 'cause he's paying cash down for these. Who says that he don't know what it's all about? He's gonna run the town till they run him out. Maybe you know why such a cockeyed guy became the cockeyed mayor of Kaunakakai. He hardly ever shows what he honestly thinks of you. His right eye doesn't know what his left eye is gonna do. My goodness, he don't know what it's all about. He's gonna run the town till they run him out. Maybe you know why such a cockeyed guy became the cockeyed mayor of Kaunakakai. You know why such a cockeyed guy became the cockeyed mayor of Kaunakakai.
And if the mayor is listening, we're only kidding, Your Honor. Next, we bring you one of the most beautiful and best-loved songs of the islands, the famous Hawaiian wedding song. To sing it, we have our popular young married couple, Guy and Ralna.
This is the moment I've waited for. I can hear my heart singing. Soon bells will be ringing. This is the moment of sweet aloha.
I will love you longer than forever.
Promise me that you will leave me never.
That we are one, clouds won't hide the sun, blue skies of Hawaii smile on this our wedding day. I do.
Never tire of listening to those great duets by Guy and Ralna. Now coming up, I get to help the Candilo production of Lovely Hula Hands, and the whole cast sings Song of the Islands. At the end of this program, I'll visit with Charlotte Harris, our talented cellist, and talk about her many years on the Welk Show. But now, let's go back to Hawaii.
Friends, Hawaii is a wonderful, wonderful place to relax. And right now we have some very pretty music to put you in a relaxing mood. Charlotte and her cello with Bob Ralston at the organ. The song, Blue Hawaii. Pleasant, Charlotte and Bob. Either Duncan hasn't switched to the hula yet, and maybe it's just as well. But he's still a master when it comes to tap dancing. And here he is with some of his fancy footwork, dancing to the song, Drifting and Dreaming.
I've always enjoyed Arthur's dancing, but I think here on Waikiki, he gets a little extra spring in his feet.
Oh, noticed that, Myron. Must be the coconuts, huh?
Yeah. Well, whatever it is,
you know. Pineapple, maybe.
Joe Feeney and I have been visiting with the nice folks here at the Princess Kaiolani, and we've discovered that a song written by a good friend of ours, Harry Owens, is still one of the big request songs here in the islands. We'd like to do it for you right now. Joe Feeney, feel up to Sweet Leilani.
Oh, I'd love to sing. It's such a beautiful audience here, huh? Right.
Sweet Leilani, heavenly flower, old-fashioned roses kissed her too.
I love this.
Thank you. And then she placed them in a bower. It was the start of you. Sweet Leilani, now Myron, heavenly flower, I dreamed of paradise for two.
Don't forget the kids, Myron.
You are my paradise completed. You are my dream come true. Sweet Leilani, heavenly flower, I dreamed of paradise for two.
Hello there.
You are my paradise completed. You are my dream.
A song they call the Hawaiian War Chant, which for those of you who know it is really a mouthful. Well, Sandy and Sally have been brushing up on their Hawaiian, so as our catamaran cruise continues, here they are with Hawaiian War Chant.
let's do something on the romantic side, like the Maori farewell song. All right, and it'll be sung by our very romantic popular duo, Norma Zimmer and Jimmy Roberts.
Attending a luau. Back in North Dakota, I guess we'd call it a picnic. Lots of food, singing, dancing, and fun. Come on along as Ken Deal starts the entertainment.
Lovely hula hands, graceful as a bird in motion. Gliding like the gulls or the ocean, lovely hula hands, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. White Hawaiian sands, nothing in this tropic splendor. Like the lightest touch of your slender, lovely hula hands, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. When our fingertips are meeting, gently they convey more than words can say, and my heart so madly beating gladly understands all the tender meaning of your hula hands, fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hands, doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo. When our fingertips are meeting, gently they convey more than words can say, and my heart so madly beating gladly understands all the tender meaning of your hula hands, fingertips that say aloha. Say to me again, I love you, lovely hula hands, those lovely hula hands.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. This is a great place for a luau here at the beautiful courtyard of the Royal Hawaiian Hotel. Just great. And to add to our festivities, this afternoon we have Bob Lito and his musical Beachcombers and their swinging version of that old hit, the pagan love song, assisted by some of our beautiful wahinis. To you folks on land, that's girls. Take it away, Bob.
Hey, native hills are calling. To them we belong, and we'll cheer each other with
folks, it's impossible to describe the charm and beauty of Hawaii. I'm sure I don't have the words to do it. But our fine camera crew has put together some film which will give you an idea of the gorgeous scenery to be found in this paradise of the Pacific. Please watch as our boys and girls sing the song of the islands.
With us on our trip to Hawaii. My special guest is a consummate musician and the only woman ever to be a regular member of the Lawrence Welk Orchestra. Please welcome our fabulous cellist, Miss Charlotte Harris. I'm so glad you're here with us, Charlotte.
Well, thank you so much, Mary Lou. I'm very happy to be here, too.
Did this show bring back some memories for you?
Oh, it brought back a lot of memories. This is the first time I was in Hawaii, so it was a particular thrill. And Rose picked such beautiful, colorful costumes. And another thing, it was so nice to have the audience participate in some of our numbers, too. My older daughter found out that we were going to be in Hawaii, so she flew in the day before, and she met us at the plane. Oh. It was such a thrill.
Oh, how wonderful. Now, you're from the Chicago area. Did you come from a musical family?
Yes, I did. I lived in Maywood, Illinois, about 10 miles west of Chicago until I was 14. And then we moved to River Forest, Illinois. My dad was in the advertising business, and in 1933, he originated the slide rule calculator chart company. It was based on the slide rule principle. And he also had a beautiful, beautiful baritone voice, and he played piano by ear. And one of those calculators I actually made of the Lawrence Welk Band many years ago.
And I have one.
Oh, you do? How wonderful.
And your mom? And
My mother was a professional violinist. Years before, she had had a very large music school with her twin sister who played the piano. And my mother started each one of us when we were 3 years old on an instrument. My older sister got the violin, I got the piano. My younger brother came along 6 years later and he got piano also. And my younger sister got the violin. And we had such fun. All six of us in our family have perfect pitch, so we had a lot of fun with that. And when my sister was in first grade, she joined the grammar school orchestra. And I used to take my coloring book and crayons along, and my mother took us, and I listened to the orchestra play. And it wasn't long before I begged my mother to give me an instrument where I could play too. So she gave me the violin. Well, after a few weeks of that, I grabbed my sister's violin one day, and I ran through the house with it, and I fell on it. And my mother said, "That's enough of this. I'm going to give you an instrument that you can't run with." So cello it was, and I was so glad.
Well, she made history with that one. Now, you turned professional at the age of 12.
Yes, I did. I was playing in a lot of state, it was district and state contests. From the grammar school orchestra. The whole town loved music, and we played everywhere. And something I forgot to tell you about that is we traveled all over, and to St. Louis even. And the conductor got out at the concert, and he wanted the youngest member of the orchestra to stand up. And that, of course, was supposed to be me. But my sister had to stand up and say I'd gotten chicken pox the day before, so I didn't get to go at all. But we played in these district and state contests, and we auditioned on our instruments. So I had piano and cello, and we had a string trio that we competed on, plus the grammar school orchestras from all over the state. And I eventually won 32 medals. Well, when I was in sixth grade, the music supervisor called my mother, and she suggested that I not compete anymore because they wanted to give someone else a chance. So I just decided, well, I'll be professional. And a few months later, our string trio got a job of playing 3 hours for a beautiful art exhibit, and we each made $12. So I thought that was wonderful.
The beginning of a professional career. Is it true you never graduated from high school?
That's true. I was awfully busy teaching. I was teaching the kids in our neighborhood, and pretty soon their mothers wanted to take two. Well, finally, I couldn't keep all of that up. So I just played my concerts, and I kept getting out of high school all the time because some of them were in the afternoon. But one day, I happened to be looking at a college entrance exams for my older sister. And one of them said, a little paragraph there said, entrance requirements for non-high school graduates. And I had those requirements, so I just decided I'd go to college. And so I took the entrance exams for Northwestern University, and they accepted me. And so instead of being a senior, that following year I was a freshman in college.
Oh my gosh. Now, how did you ever get to the Lawrence Welk Show?
Well, that was rather exciting. I was auditioning for the show, and I walked into the theater, and this very good-looking man with a bright red sweater on and casual clothes came over, and he just started teasing me. And I thought, oh my, what is this going to be? So I finally realized he had an accent, and I was very calm about everything, and he introduced himself then, and he was Lawrence Welk.
And you didn't recognize him?
No, I'd never seen the show. So I didn't know what Lawrence Welk looked like. But anyway, that's what happened, and he asked me, I played a few of my lighter cello numbers, and then he asked me, can I play this popular tune? Well, I never remembered the name of any popular tune, but if I heard it, I could play it. So I said, well, how does it go? And he hummed a few bars there, and I played the piece. And we went through this two or three times, and then he said, I'd like you to play on my show Saturday, and I'd like you to play a piece called Lullaby that I wrote. And so I did that Saturday night. And the following Saturday night, I played again. And the third Saturday, they had someone else they had promised to try. And after the show that night, they called me up and gave me the job. And
oh,
I was thrilled.
Wonderful. Wonderful. Now, you've always taught. And
yes.
Now you and your husband, Ed, have the Deveni Music School.
That's right.
How is that? Are you enjoying it?
Oh, I love to teach. I've taught ever since I was a child, and he loves to teach, too. But he was a concert pianist, and we decided that we just didn't want to travel anymore. So we formed our school. I already had had quite a few students, and we have students of all ages. I love to take the young students, and he takes the older students. So we have, on our business card, it says beginner to concert stage.
Oh.
And that's exactly what it is. Some of our students have played with symphonies over in Europe, and we have one getting her master's degree at Northwestern University now.
Your alma mater.
Oh, yes.
What's the best lesson you ever learned from Lawrence Welk?
Well, Lawrence and I had a lot of time to talk. Soon as I got on the band, I discovered that in River Forest, Illinois, we lived exactly two blocks away from each other. And when I moved out to Brentwood, California, my goodness, if we weren't two blocks away from each other. So occasionally we would ride to work together. And Lawrence had some wonderful ways of living life, very different, different from most people, but very much like my parents. And one thing he always told me, I never forgot, if you don't get better, you get worse. And I think it's a wonderful way to live by.
That is great words to live by.
I think so.
Oh, Charlotte, I'm so glad you've been here to visit with us. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're very welcome. I loved it too.
And thank you so much. We love coming and visiting with you. And as Lawrence Welk always said, keep a song in your heart.
Sleep tight and pleasant dreams to you. Here's a wish.